We've got some activity on the second floor. The exciting thing is that's Duroc. And the tile guys are here. And we are starting to prep for the main bedroom shower. So we're starting up here. Cannot wait to see this tile go up. This tile is amazing. It's gonna look so good. All right, we are up in the main bathroom. And this is not news to me, and it's certainly not news to you, but it was news to the tile guys that nothing in the house is plumb, including this wall of the shower. And what that was gonna do is have about 3 inches of change from the top to the bottom, which meant we were gonna have like a sliver of tile down here and like 3 inches of tile up here. So he wanted to do it right, which I certainly appreciate. And he furred this wall out. So now it is completely plumb, on the money. This shower is gonna look fantastic. So we're getting that Duroc back up again. We got it up there once when they discovered it wasn't plumb. And we're getting ready to put that Duroc up again. Step two, or really step three, because step one was getting the wall level and plumb. Step three is getting a water sealant on all the Duroc. And it's a lovely teal color. Holy moly, y'all. This looks so good. I mean, I thought I liked this tile in a sample, but when I see it on the walls, the variation and the color and the finish, this is an oyster finish. You know that we found all kind of oyster shells under the house, out in the yard. So that's kind of what inspired this. But, you know, there's nothing perfect in this house. And so I didn't want a perfect tile either. So, so gorgeous. This is the main bedroom shower, and it's also going to be the backsplash as well. I'm so excited about an update on the main bedroom shower. My goodness, y'all, it's so, so pretty. I'm looking at it in person, and I'm looking at it on my screen, and it is 10 times prettier in person. So the next step is we're going to move over on this wall. We're going to build 2 niches here. We're going to do a 6-inch one for like soap and stuff, and then a 12-inch one for shampoo and all that stuff. I like to put it on the back wall so you don't see it. So when you first walk in, you don't see like purple shampoo and stuff. So you'll just have this one solid wall of perfection. Gosh, this tile is so, so pretty. I love that some are shinier and some are more matte. There's color variation. Just could not be prettier. I am up in the main bedroom. There's things happening all over the house, but I'm just so excited that I can't leave this bathroom. So here's one of our niches. This is our big one. And then we have a smaller one that's yet to be made. It's gonna be half this height. So these are gonna go right in here on this back wall. I can't get enough, people. I can't get enough. It's so, so awesome. The niches are in. Look, we've already tiled up about, gosh, more than half. So we've got our little niche and our big niche. And I think it's great. Looks so, so good. Are you tired of hearing me say that? I don't care. I'm going to keep saying it. I love it. It's another new day. We are still laying tile. In fact, the guys got here early this morning. I don't know what they've accomplished inside. So let's go upstairs and see. Okay, we're in the main bedroom. And I've been told that they have finished tiling this bathroom. Goodness, that looks good. Now they still have to tile in the niche, and okay, so this isn't quite done. We've got to finish in that niche, and we've got to add the bullnose trim tile here. You can see it's there. It's got a pretty rounded edge, but it looks so good, so good. We still got to tile in the niche, and if you hear banging, the second floor bathroom, which is on the other side of that wall, they're almost done with the floor in there. Go check it out. All right. So you remember back when we went to Chubby's and picked all this out, it's just, a really basic hex tile, a classic for an older home. There wouldn't have been tile in this home at all, but it's still a good older tile or an older house tile. So hex tile in here, same floor is going to go in the ground floor bathroom as well. But they have knocked this out. It looks really good. Next, we're going to tile the walls. We're going to tile that back wall and this wall because our clawfoot tub is going to go right here. So that way you'll have tile all around that. I think it looks great, y'all. Check it out. The clawfoot tub bathroom floor is done. I love it. Like I said, it's a real historic tile. There's really nothing special about it, especially after that main bedroom. But I like it. So we're gonna get the walls going in here. I actually think we're gonna jump to the third floor and knock out that shower first before we get here because we're actually missing the Schluter, which is the little metal trim that's gonna go along the top in here. So hopefully, fingers crossed, that will be here soon. But this turned out really well. I think I probably already told you, but this is the same floor for the bathroom downstairs. So checking in on the main bathroom. It is finished. The niche is done. Our bullnose trim is done on the end. This one is just ready for grout. And they have moved upstairs. They are hanging Duroc on the third floor. So we're gonna go up there, check that out. We are on the third floor in the bathroom. You can see we're almost done with the Duroc. We gotta do a little bit here and a little bit at the top. And then this wall over here, we're gonna bring the tile out and tile that whole little triangular wall. So, almost ready to start tiling on the third floor. All right, third floor closet is coming together. We got it completely waterproofed. We got fiberglass tape in the corners. I think you can see that there. There's a tape, the teal waterproofing. So we're ready to go. We are ready to start tiling this bathroom. Lots of other stuff happening in the house, but we're gonna check in on the third floor. Moving right along. We're getting there. Our third floor shower is so pretty. It is coming together. We've got that whole wall. We've still gotta do this little short wall and all the way up. We're actually gonna tile the ceiling and everything in this one because it's tight corners. So every bit of this is gonna be tiled. I love it. This is that, I think the color is biscuit. So it's just a slightly off-white. Subway is classic. I love Subway. My whole house is Subway. But I like just the slight variation on the color. Look at all of that detailed work. And Ricky, my tile guy, is so good that this line right here goes all the way up that wall, across the ceiling, and back down from floor to floor. We've got just a little bit more to do right here, but we've got that board supporting this. We'll let that set up before we do this. But love it. Love the tiled ceiling. We made the shower head a little higher. I hate low shower heads. I always jack that thing up. I can't stand like when I stay in a hotel and I feel like the shower head's at my forehead. So this one is almost done. Almost done. It is a new day and the guys are working away on this wall, this crooked wall in the bathroom. Of course, you know, that's where our clawfoot tub's gonna go. So we're just tiling this wall, and that little bit of that wall too. So we're gonna go up about 5 feet. Basically, we're gonna figure out how it works best with that light switch when we get to the top. It's coming along. You see that little board along the bottom? So to get, the floor is not level in here. Surprise, surprise. So he put up a level board and worked from there up. And then once all of this is done, he'll come back in and fill that in at the bottom. He wanted to make sure that when he got up here at the top, that this was going to be nice and level. We've made significant progress on the Duroc in the kitchen. And what I love about this is you can see that the Duroc is not that different from the floor tile color. So you kind of get a feeling what it's going to feel like with these dark floors. We've just had, you know, plywood in here for so long, but it's feels much bigger with the Duroc. We've literally turned a corner in the clawfoot tub bathroom. We're coming around. This is going really fast and it looks fantastic. All of the Duroc is down. We are ready to start working on tile. We're gonna take the tile into the fireplace and it's a little bit low and rough looking. So we're gonna pour concrete in there to get it level with the Duroc, and then our tile is just gonna run right into that. It's gonna be exciting. You remember we jacked these cabinets up an inch. So our quarter inch Duroc has eaten up a quarter of those little feet under there. We've got a half inch tile, and then that'll give us a quarter inch of thin set to do as well. I can't wait to see this tile go down. And the concrete for that fireplace just arrived. So hopefully we can catch them putting that down and see how that's gonna level up. All right, the concrete is going down. We'll get that as level as we can with our Duroc floor. And as you can see, they're getting ready to put some tile down. We have tile happening everywhere, ground floor, second floor, third floor. These walls are still coming together, looking really good. Of course, we know that corner over there is super crooked. Inside the house, or non-tile, somewhat tile related, we are painting the inside of that fireplace because that's also gonna get tiled. So we're gonna paint now so we don't take a chance on getting the paint on the tile. And the first two pieces are down. It's a pretty big tile, so it's gonna move pretty quick. Pretty quick. So these guys have made really good progress for one afternoon in the kitchen. I'm loving the slate. I love the variation in the colors. I love the little dips and dents that's in it. Some of the slices or the pieces of tile vary just a little bit in thickness. So the guys are having to be really careful about putting just enough mud underneath each individual board so that they are level and we don't have trip hazards or toe stumpers. So almost ready to go into the fireplace, and it's a good day's work. Okay, y'all, so it's a terrible day, but we got a lot of good work done. So that's a wrap on week one of tiling. I am really happy with how it's looking, and I can't wait to see it all finished and grouted. So stay tuned for that.